क्वेश्चन अर्लियर क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इजी टू सॉल्व. हियर यू आर गिवन द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स इन द फर्स्ट रो एंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ वाई इन द सेकंड रो एंड यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट द एरिया बाउंडेड बाय द कर्व द एक्स एक्सिस एंड द एक्सट्रीम ऑर्डिनेट्स. यू नो दैट द एरिया ऑफ ए कर्व इज गिवन बाय इंटीग्रल वाई डी एक्स वेयर हियर एक्स इज वेरिंग फ्रॉम 0 टू 4.0. यू कैन सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम वेरी इजली. The next topic is Simpson's 1/3 rule and also composite Simpson's 1/3 rule. See, the general numerical integration formula is integration from x0 to xn y dx is equal to n into h within bracket y0 plus n by 2 forward difference operator on y0 plus n into 2n minus 3 by 12 second order forward difference operator on y0 plus n into n minus 2 whole square by 24 third order forward difference operator on y0 plus so on. We have used this formula to derive trapezoidal rules also. So let us see this rule, Simpson's 1/3 rule. We substitute here n is equal to 2 in the above general formula. It means the curve is replaced by n by 2 arcs of second degree polynomials or parabolas. So after substituting n is equal to 2 in the earlier equation, you get integration from x0 to x2 y dx is equal to 2 into h y0 plus 2 by 2 into forward difference on y0 plus 2 into within bracket 2 into 2 minus 3 by 12 second order forward difference y0, and the rest are neglected because that will they will be 0. This is equal to 2h within bracket y0 plus y1 minus y0 plus 1 by 6 y2 minus 2y1 plus y0. So it is equal to h by 3 y0 plus 4y1 plus y2. Similarly, we can calculate integration from x2 to x4 y dx is equal to h by 3 y2 plus 4y3 plus y4. This is equation 2, this is equation 3. And so on, proceed in this manner, you get integration from xn minus 2 to xn y dx is equal to h by 3 and within bracket yn minus 2 plus 4 times yn minus 1 plus yn. Now you need to add all of these equations. So add all above and get integration from x0 to xn y dx is equal to integration from x0 to x2 y dx plus integration from x2 to x4 y dx plus 1 plus integration from xn minus 2 to xn y dx. This is equal to h by 3 within bracket y0 plus 4 times y1 plus y3 plus 1 plus yn minus 1 plus 2 times y2 plus y4 plus 1 plus yn minus 2 plus yn. So this formula is called as composite Simpson's 1/3 rule. And Simpson's 1/3 rule is simply this one. H by 3 y0 plus 4yn plus y2. So this formula is clear to you. We will have two examples on this. There is a note. This rule divides the whole range into an even number of subintervals of its h. So let us see some examples based on this one. Means examples on Simpson's 1/3 rule and composite Simpson's 1/3 rule. We have written again the Simpson's 1/3 rule. Integration from x0 to x2 y dx is h by 3. Y0 plus 4y1 plus y2, and Simpson's composite 1/3 rule is integration from x0 to xn y dx is h by 3 into y0 plus 4y1 plus y3 plus 1 plus yn minus 1 plus 2 y2 plus y4 plus 1 plus yn minus 2 plus yn. Now the whole range has a division into an even number of subintervals of its h. There is an example. See, evaluate integration from 1 to 3 1 by x dx by Simpson's rule with 4 strips and 8 strips respectively. So see the solution. With 4 strips, we have h is given as b minus a by n. So here b is your 3, a is your 1. So it is 3 minus 1 by n, n is your 4 because it is for 4 strip. So h comes out to be 0.5. And our function y is 1 by x. So we will write the values in tabular form as in the first row, the values of x, and in the second row, the values of y equal to 1 by x. So the values of x will be 1, And then since h is 0.5, so 1.1 plus 0.5 is 0.5. Similarly, 1.5 plus 0.5 is 2, 2.5 and 3. And the corresponding values of y equal to 1 by x are 1 by 1 means 1, 1 by 1.5 means 2 by 3, 1 by 2, 1 by 2.5 means 2 by 5, 1 by 3 means the 1 by 3. Now, by Simpson's composite 1 by 3 rule, we have integration from 1 to 3, 1 by x dx is equal to h upon 3. Within bracket y0 plus 4, y1 plus y3 plus 2, y2 plus y4. See here, this is your y0, y1, y2, y3 and y4. Substitute the values. So it is 0.5 by 3 into 1 plus 4, 2 by 3 plus 2 by 5 plus 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3. Its value comes out to be 1.1. So this is the solution for the given problem with 4 steps. Now we take 8 steps. So with 8 steps, h will be 3 minus 1 by 8, means it is 1 by 4. Therefore, we will write the tabulated values of x and y in the next. In the next, we will see the tabulated values of x and y. See, x is given as 1, 5 by 4, 1 plus 1 by 4 means 5 by 4, 3 by 2, 7 by 4, 2, 9 by 4, 5 by 2, 11 by 4, and 3. Y equal to 1 by x is given as 1, 4 by 5, 2 by 3, 4 by 7, 1 by 2, 4 by 9, 2 by 5, 4 by 11, and 1 by 3. Now we use Simpson's composite 1 by 3 rule and get integration from 1 to 3, 1 by x dx is equal to h upon 3 within bracket y0 plus 4, y1 plus y3 plus y5 plus y7 plus 2 times y2 plus y4 plus y6 plus y8. See, this is your y0, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6, y7, and y8. So this is equal to 1 by 4 by 3. 1 by 4 means h is your 1 by 4. And within bracket, y0 means 1 plus 4 into 4 by 5 plus 4 by 7 plus 4 by 9 plus 4 by 11 plus 2 into 2 by 3 plus 1 by 2 plus 2 by 5 plus 1 by 3. So compute this and you get 1.09923. So this is the solution for the given problem for 4 steps and 8 steps respectively. There is another problem. See the problem first. We can solve it. The velocities of a car running on a straight road at intervals of 2 minutes are given below. See, in the first row, we have time in minutes 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, and 12. And in the second row, velocity in kilometers per hour. 0, 22, 30, 27, 18, 7, and 0. Apply Simpson's 1 by 3 rule to find the distance covered by the car. See, we know that distance is given as velocity into time. So distance formula will be taken as d is equal to integration v into dt, where v t is varying from 0 to 12. See here, it is time is with an interval of 2 minutes, that is why 0 plus 2 means 2 minutes, 2 plus 2 means 4 minutes, 4 plus 2 means 6 minutes, and so on. So also this time is given in minutes, but velocity is given in kilometers per hour. So better to change this time in minutes into hours. So since 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour, so 0 minute will be 0 by 60 hours, 2 minutes means 2 by 60 hour, 4 minutes means 4 by 60 hour, and so on. See the solution. First, we should convert the units of time to hours. After conversion, the table is rewritten as time in hours 0, 2 by 60, 4 by 60, 6 by 60, 8 by 60, 10 by 60, and 12 by 60. And the velocity in kilometer per hour are 0, 22, 30, 27, 18, 7, and 0. Now you apply Simpson's 1 by 3 rule, that is integration from x. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. There are 6. So x0 to x6 means, so velocities will be, this is your v0, v1, v2, v3, v4, v5, and v6. So you can very easily evaluate using Simpson's 1 by 3 rule. No need to go to solve this problem. If you face any difficulty, you just send me a message in my WhatsApp number And also this lecture will be available on YouTube. So you can send me the message in the YouTube comment section. I will solve your difficulties.